Welcome to BVS Pragati channel. In this session, let's have a look at some multiple choice questions related to network systems. The switch S in the circuit shown in figure is idle. If the switch is repeatedly closed for 1 millisecond and open for 1 millisecond, the average value of IT is. So here, the switch I is closed for 1 millisecond. So when it is closed, I is equal to 5/10k, that is 0.5 milliamps. Now when it is open, the current I is 0. So this is how it looks like. So for 1 millisecond, the current is 0.5 milliamps, and for remaining time when switch is open, it is 0. So the average value is 0.5 plus 0 by 2. That is, it is equal to 0.25 milliamps. So the right answer is D. In the circuit of figure, the idle switch S alternately stays at position A for 1 millisecond and at position B for 4 milliseconds. Okay, the average value of current IT is, now this is the switch S, okay, when it is in position A, what happens? The current is I is equal to 5/5k, that is 1 milliamps, and when it is at position B, the current is 5/10k, that is 0.5 milliamps for 4 milliseconds, right? So in that case, the current looks like this. This is what is the calculation, and the current looks like this. For 1 millisecond, the current is 1. For the remaining 4 milliseconds, the current is 0.5 milliamps. So what is I average? It is 1/5 integral of 0 to 5 it into dt. So 1/5 is 0 to 1, from 0 to 1 millisecond it is 1 into dt, plus from 1 to 5 millisecond it is 0.5 dt. So 1/5 into 1 plus 0.5 into 4. Okay, do the integration. So you get 0.6 milliamps. Okay, so the correct answer is A. Now let's have a look at the other question. Let's have a look at the circuit. Okay, so how is the voltage V1 and V2 related? Now, what V1 minus V2 will be equal to 6 plus 8. 6 IA plus 8. So, if you apply KVL, we get. So, that is what it is. V1 minus V2 is equal to 6 IA plus 8. Or V1 is equal to 6 IA plus 8 plus V2. So, B is the correct answer. Now, let's have a look at some more questions. In the circuit of figure, the current I2 is, so apply Kirchhoff's current law. So when you apply KCL, so what happens? I1 is entering this junction, okay? And Ix is also entering this junction. And this 14 amps is leaving the junction. So I1 plus Ix is equal to 14 amps, okay? And if you see here, this is 2 amps, so Ix is 2 amps. And if you see, I2 is leaving the junction, I1 is leaving the junction. So, Ix is equal to I1 plus I2. Now, you know what Ix is? It is 2 amps, right? So, I1 plus Ix is 14 amps. We got it. So, I1 is 12 amps. Now, you have one more equation. I1 plus I2 is Ix. So, you know I1, Ix, substitute the values. You get I2 is equal to minus 10 milliamps. So, B1 is the correct answer. Sorry, B is the correct answer. If a resistor of 10 ohms is placed in parallel with voltage source in the circuit of figure, the current I will be constant. There won't be any change because the V is still the same. So the right answer is C. The current through an 8 kilo ohm resistor is given in figure. The total charge transferred in time interval t is equal to 0 to t equals 2 seconds is. So here is the figure. Okay, from 0 to 1, the current is 2 milliamps. And from 1 to 2 seconds, the current is minus 2 milliamps. So what is the total charge? So what is Q? It will be integral of I dt, that is the area. So net area is 0. So you see that. There is an equivalent positive value, there is an equivalent negative value. So if you add all the values, The current is, the net current is 0. So D is the correct answer. So what is the charge? The total charge is 0. Since current is 0, total charge is also 0. The voltage VL in figure is related to current IL according to, so VL is given by this formula, okay? So this is the circuit. So this is supplying VL and the current IL is flowing in the load containing nonlinear resistor. So value of IL that maximizes the power absorbed by load is, now what is power? VL into IL. So 16 minus 4 IL square into IL. So anyway, this is 0 at IL greater than or equals to 2. So 16 minus 4 IL square into IL. How do you calculate the maximum power? Do the differentiation with respect to IL. dP by dIL is equal to, so if you differentiate this with respect to IL, you get 16 minus twice IL square. So IL is equal to 1.155 amps. So D is the correct answer. So that's all for this session. More in the next session. Thank you. Thanks a lot and I wish you all the best.